Welcome to WebStylePress, Bootstrap 3, Bootstrap 4. What are major differences between Bootstrap 3 and Bootstrap 4? This is often part of front-end interview questions that most front-end developers fail to answer properly. If you are a front-end developer and don't know what's going on with the frameworks and libraries that you use regularly, then you lack important information. Libraries and frameworks won't get updated to just include few more classes and new pretty colors. It has to be more specific than that. And you may wonder, why are you being asked about Bootstrap 3? Because it's relevant. Why? Because you will still have to work on websites that are using Bootstrap version 3 at your job. Also, interviews are not about testing what can you do. It's about how much you pay attention to details and how much grip do you have on your subject. Okay, here we go. First, I will show you important differences, then I will tell you what are most important. Bootstrap 4 switched from LESS to SASS for source CSS files. SASS proved to be powerful than LESS. Web developers adopted SASS more than LESS. SASS is also more supported by frameworks and libraries. Bootstrap 4 switched from pixels to rem as Bootstrap's primary CSS unit. However, pixels was still used for media queries. Global font size increased from 14 pixels to 16 pixels in Bootstrap 4. Also for global font family, Bootstrap 4 preferred system fonts as first priority. Flexbox is one of the most important and crucial features of Bootstrap 4, which makes it different from Bootstrap 3. You can quickly manage layout alignments, change size of grid columns and components. Flexbox helps you manage formation of complex layouts with ease. Bootstrap 3 used floats to handle the layout, unlike Bootstrap 4 that is using Flexbox. Flexbox makes it easier to design flexible, responsive layout structure without using float or positioning. If you are still using CSS floats, you should drop it and use CSS Flexbox. CSS Flexbox is really a good addition in Bootstrap 4. Bootstrap 3 had 4-tier grid system containing XS, SM, MD, and LG. But Bootstrap 4 uses a 5-tier grid system. Bootstrap 4 removed XS breakpoint and added XL. However, in Bootstrap 4, you can use just call for auto column width, or you can specify column width with a number like 1, 2, 3, call-6, 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 will use 50% column width. Call covers all devices starting from lower breakpoint. Because call hyphen and number covers all devices, so no need to specify the size like MD, SM, XL in this case. Bootstrap 4 grid system was improved and corrected for different breakpoints. Extra large or XL in Bootstrap 4 is same as large or LG in Bootstrap 3. This means the change occurred for small devices breakpoints that were improved a lot in Bootstrap 4. For images, img-responsive class was changed to img-fluid. As a bonus tip, use d-block and mx-auto to centerline images in Bootstrap 4. Limited colors are available in Bootstrap 3. In Bootstrap 4, more color options are available for text, background, and components. You can also modify or extend relevant classes easily in Bootstrap 4. Bootstrap 3 had few icons included with it. Bootstrap 4 dropped icons. Many devs don't need or want icons in Bootstrap. Many developers use other icon font libraries such as Font Awesome. Bootstrap including its own icon fonts was an unnecessary bloat, according to many developers. Dedicated icon font projects could do a better job. Wells, panels, and thumbnails are supported in Bootstrap 3, but in Bootstrap 4, we use cards instead. Bootstrap 4 can also be installed by using package manager like npm, but Bootstrap 3 has no such option. Dark or inverse classes are present in Bootstrap 4, unlike Bootstrap 3. Also, new classes were added in Bootstrap 4, and few classes were removed. For navigation, images, media objects, tables, buttons, button groups, forms, input groups, list groups, dropdowns, typography, pagination, breadcrumbs, progress bar, classes were changed or added new classes and removed few classes in Bootstrap 4. I won't go into details on it for each element and component, because that you will be able to experience yourself when you will work with Bootstrap 4. Twitter Bootstrap is the first choice of front-end developers. It is a trusted open source framework to develop modern websites and applications quickly. A most popular HTML, CSS, and JS framework for developing responsive websites. Twitter Bootstrap provides the basic structure of HTML and CSS with preferred classes, which help you to build functionality quickly and easily with device responsiveness. It saves plenty of time. With almost every front-end developer using it, it is mandatory to understand changes that it has gone through. So, if interviewer asks about the major differences between Bootstrap 3 and Bootstrap 4, you can say that Bootstrap dropped less and adopted SASS in Bootstrap 4. CSS floats were dropped and CSS Flexbox was adopted in Bootstrap 4. RAM was adopted as global CSS unit instead of pixels. Global font size was increased and grid system was improved. These were the most important and major changes from Bootstrap 3 to Bootstrap 4. As a front-end developer, you cannot ignore these changes. And as a front-end developer, you should know why it's important to switch from LESS to SASS and from CSS floats to CSS Flexbox. But that is for another video. And as far as which version to use is concerned, if project is already using Bootstrap 3, use Bootstrap 3. And migrate gradually. Otherwise, Flexbox alone is a solid reason to prefer Bootstrap 4 over Bootstrap 3, or just use latest version of Bootstrap. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.